Hi! If you haven't seen the trailer for No Man's Sky from E3 2015, you'll want to check it out. The interesting takeaway from the trailer is everything in the game is procedurally generated content. What does that mean? It means every level, every world, every plant, every creature is randomly generated by the computer. Well, that sounds great, but how do you make sure the world isn't completely new when you come back to it? There's a trick to it, and that's what I'm going to show you in this video. The key to a good game is randomness. Randomness is what makes the game interesting. If the player knows what to expect at every turn, the game quickly becomes boring. We've all seen this in video games. If you remember the game Dragon's Lair, it had awesome graphics for the time. It was like watching a cartoon. However, nothing was random. Once you figured out the pattern, the game became very boring. There was no replay value at all. Platform games like Mario and Sonic are the same. Even Call of Duty. There's more moving on the screen, which makes it seem a bit more random. The levels are much deeper, and it takes longer to get through. But once you're done, you're done. The reason is, these games were planned out by the developer ahead of time. They want to make sure there's a bad guy guarding the chest every time. They want to make sure the game is consistent between play, and more difficult the further you go. The trade-off is, the game will end. It doesn't have to be this way. You can make a game that makes more content the further you go. Just use random numbers to generate everything. Randomly generate where the world is, where the bad guys are, what they look like, where the cities and merchants are, and so on. This means you don't have to waste hard drive space for every level. Just generate a new one and the player can play forever. The one problem with this is, if you're always using random numbers, everything's going to be random. If your game is a space game, you want stars and planets to be predictable. They should always be in the same place. Otherwise, the player is going to be forever lost. It's a contradiction. You want randomness, but you also want predictability. When you turn off your computer, you want to return to the world you were playing. Not a completely different one. So what do we do? Here's an interesting thought. Random numbers on a computer are not random. In fact, there's no such thing as random number on a computer. Computers are deterministic, so it's impossible for it to generate a random number. Computers can generate a list of numbers that appear to be random, but you can always generate the same exact list of random numbers. Every random number generator uses something called a seed number. This number tells your random number generator where to start. If you don't provide a seed value, your computer will use something like the time of day. If you can predict the number your computer's using, you can predict the random number sequence. Let me show you this in code. All right, here I have some code where we set up a random object and we print out the next 10 random numbers between 1 and 100. We run it and it prints out 10 random numbers, 12, 14, 80. We run it again. And they're different random numbers, 42, 46, 63. Now I told you we could generate the same exact random numbers if we seeded it. So if we go back to our code and we add random.setSeed equal, let's say to 42. Now when we run it, we get the list 30, 63, 48, 84. We run it again, and we get the same exact list, 30, 63, 48. The reason is, this statement, randoms.setSeed, is telling us where to start in our random numbers. We'll always start at the same exact place, so we'll generate the same list every time. Well, we know that the numbers a computer does generate look random. So to keep things simple, let's create a universe that is 5x5. That gives us 25 regions in our universe. Each region has a galaxy. We can say every position has an XY coordinate from 0 to 4. We can encode each position in the map with 2 digits. The first digit is the X, the second is the Y. We now have a unique seed for each galaxy in our universe. Say we have 3 different types of galaxies: spiral, elliptical, and irregular. For each position, we seed our random number generator with the position. Then we generate a number from 0 to 2. That'll give us our galaxy type. We'll then generate a galaxy type for each position in our matrix. When we're done, we'll have a random galaxy in each position of our universe. Since we're seeding our random number generator, we'll get the same universe every time we generate this. Let's go try that. So in this code, we're going to generate our universe. I've created an array of characters to represent our galaxy type. S for symmetrical, E for elliptical, I for irregular. What we're going to do is we're going to loop for every position in our game space from I equals 0 to I less than 5. So that should go 0 to 4. And then for that, I loop in an inner loop 0 to 4 for the Y's. That will generate a position for every location in our universe. For every position, we call getGalaxy at ij, which calls a method getGalaxy with the coordinates x, y. For that coordinate, we generate the seed for that position. So when we're at 0, 0, the seed will be 0. When we're at 0, 1, seed will be 1, and so on. Every position in our galaxy, or our universe, will have a unique seed. We'll generate a galaxy type and return it, and we'll print it out. So let's see what happens. We run it, and you can see down here we have our universe of randomly arranged galaxies. Now if we come back in, clear it out, run it again, we get the exact same universe that we got before. And that's because we're seeding every galaxy position, or every universe position, with the position seed on our matrix. We now have a procedure that can tell us the type of galaxy at a given position. We don't need to store the information when we need it. We just need to generate it using the same position seed. This is called procedurally generated content. That's the secret sauce in No Man's Sky. When you use the same seed, you'll generate the exact same sequence. So if your seed is 42, it will always generate irregular. While our universe looks random, it'll be the same every time you generate it. When a player enters a galaxy, you can then break up the galaxy into smaller parts and use those locations as seeds to randomly generate stars, star positions, star types, etc. Again, you use the same seed. You keep doing this all the way down to the surface of the planet. Using pseudo-random numbers in the terrain engine, the planet will look the same every time you visit it. Just plug in the seed and generate the same random planet. Mountains will generate in the same place. Cities will generate in the same place. Where they are from planet to planet will be different. You apply the rules on how the game artifacts are generated, and the computer will generate the same random list of numbers. Now we did our universe example with a 5x5 matrix. Imagine if it was thousands by thousands. It won't take more space in our game. We just use the position to calculate the seed value, but the playing field will be dramatically larger. Hopefully you see the way that this can scale. Really, the only things you need to keep track of are important game objects that can be affected by time. If it can be moved and you need to remember its position, just save that game object separate from your procedurally generated content.
Now this video oversimplified many things. For example, every region has to have a unique seed. Otherwise, you're going to get areas that repeat. That can force you down paths of encoding information in your seeds like we did for our universe with the X and Y coordinates. How do you handle crossing the universe's edge? Ideally, you'd want a new region to be generated and for your game to go on forever. The procedures to generate more complex things, like cities and roads, can get complex. The point is, this isn't all a magic bullet. You're trading off storage and design requirements for procedural complexity in your code. Well, hopefully this gives you some exciting ideas for your next game. If you want to see more videos on this topic, please let me know in the comments below. See you in the next video.